when I tell people what I do, there's generally a sort of brief moment of complete silence, and then it's followed by lots and lots of questions.
David Mearns is a shipwreck hunter.
I think I did have some natural skills and interests that sort of made me good at what I do. I always liked research, you know, and finding these shipwrecks, you start research in archives. So you're looking for clues. You're working like a detective.
Historical record is the seed of much of David's work, and also his passion.
The biggest turn on to this whole thing is really bringing that history to life, breathing new air and visual images into stuff that is just on the pages of papers in archives and libraries. This is the earliest pre-colonial shipwreck ever discovered. This is the Esmeralda shipwreck of Vicente Sodré.
Vicente Sodré was the uncle of famed explorer Vasco da Gama and commander of the Esmeralda, a ship in da Gama's fleet. In 1503, a storm sunk the Esmeralda.
It's from the European age of discovery, when Columbus, Magellan, Vasco da Gama are going around the world.
Nearly 500 years later, and after 6 months of research, David Mearns' team located the Portuguese shipwreck off the coast of Oman.
We have over 2,800 individual artifacts. And so every object we find is really the potential for completely new discoveries. And we know we're finding things that nobody else has seen before. This copper alloy metal disc is one of the most important because it has the Portuguese coat of arms and the personal emblem of Dom Manuel I, and he was the king during Vasco da Gama's reign. Instantaneously, I know we had the right shipwreck.
The Esmeralda was part of the fleet of Vasco da Gama, a Portuguese explorer who was the first European to reach India by sea. Da Gama sailed during a roughly 200-year period, now known as the Age of Exploration, which began in the mid-15th century as Europe sought out global oceanic trade routes. This boom in exploration was initially driven by the desire to reach the spice markets of the Indian subcontinent, and was another early step toward what today is called globalization, the development of an integrated global economy marked by free trade of goods and services.
We all now live with globalization, and it's a word that was probably only invented, you know, in my lifetime.
As the explorers worked to excavate the ship, tiny artifacts are some of the most amazing discoveries.
One coin in particular, the Indio, there's only one other one in the world. They call it the ghost coin of Dom Manuel I.
The rare coin was commissioned by Portuguese King Dom Manuel, specifically for trade with India.
So to find something like that, it was like, you know, this is like Hollywood story, you know?
Another exciting discovery was the copper alloy ship's bell, the earliest ship's bell ever discovered.
This bell was under this boulder for 510 years. It's in relatively good condition. What's really sort of fun about it, it matched the date that Vasco da Gama found the sea route to India. And that was part of globalization. This is really world history that we're discovering.
Who found that then? You!
With the Portuguese crown and the red emblem of the world.